In a world where climate change has considerable focus, cooling as a subject is often left out.
Cooling is overlooked as a subject because when we talk about climate change or warming the planet, we are looking about the main reasons for that. Cooling is actually 10% of the electricity consumption of the world, and we need to do something to change that.
How do we as companies actually contribute to being a positive force? My name is Shanda Campos. I am heading sustainability engagement at Grundfos. Cooling is no longer a luxury, it is a necessity because we are seeing the world is getting warmer and warmer. 30% of the world's population are living in places where it's too hot to live. We need to make sure that we have places which are comfortable and where people can actually live, you know, have a normal life. Today we have 2.2 billion in the middle class. That number is also going to be increasing exponentially. And they will be able to afford and buy an air conditioner, for example. If we don't make that cooling efficient, we have a challenge. We need to change the way we look at cooling, because cooling is also part of the problem if it's not efficient. When we are looking to how we cool our houses, our data centers, how do we cool the medicine, which is so important for us today, that it has to be done as good and as efficient as possible. The warmer the world gets, the more cooling it will need. We are buying 10 new air conditioners per second all over the world. And if these air conditioners are not as efficient as it can be, we are adding to the problem.
Cooling is becoming an increasingly large part of global warming and is a key supportive process in countless industries. And we have not even talked about space cooling yet, which has importance in both residential and commercial settings. We are many who work tirelessly on reducing energy consumption. Often it's tough and expensive to do the right thing, but not always. The potential of this service is huge. You could reduce your cooling system's energy consumption by 15 to 30%. It's installed without downtime. And if all cooling systems globally were optimized, we could potentially save the equivalent to 50% of the electricity consumption of the US. And without any operational risk, you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. To succeed, we have to cooperate. Go to the website and see how you can cool humanity without warming the planet.